Hello everyone, welcome back to Numeric Ideas YouTube channel. Today's video is going to be exciting and I can't wait to share you my thought. We will be talking about how I started my software development journey without any university degree. Of course, having a university degree is great, but even if you do have one, you can still struggle to land your dream job. When we talk about recruitment, the competition is never to be neglected, no matter how high your profile is. How many computer science students graduate each year in your country or your local area? Let's consider the Canadian tech ecosystem as an example. Each year, almost 300,000 students graduate. Maybe 10% of them are going to be disappointed after school and they will resign or change industry. Another 10% are going to be full-time entrepreneurs, creating startups or companies, no matter how you call it. We can have another 10% of margin error. I don't know why. So you still have 70% of your promotional year to compete with in order to land a job. But nowadays, the IT space is open for each country. So other people from outside of your country are going to be interested in your local area jobs as well. Just to give you a perspective, I am an example. I'm coming from Cameroon and for 2 years now, I'm working in Canada, precisely in the Quebec region. And let's not forget that maybe another 10% or 20% of people are coming from different industry in order to be in tech. So they are going to be in the competition equation. And each year passing by increase the competition or increase the difficulty for junior profiles to land a job. Because people that graduated during the precedent year will have 1 year of experience in their CV. Now, considering all of those facts, are you sure that for a specific job, you are going to be the one selected? You have to think about it. Software companies, or even better, companies in general, don't pay you to have a university degree. Instead, they pay you to produce value. Even if those who have university degrees appear to be more valuable, we can see that the most important thing here in this context is the value that you provide to the companies. So if at the end you produce or you provide more value to your companies, you are more likely to be recruited than others. Now let's come back to my story. I went to the university, but since day one, I followed some special courses in parallel. You may surely know about them already. We have some great platform, has Coursera, for example, where you can see almost any courses on all the topic that you may be interested in. I followed a free code camp curriculum as well, even if I didn't finish it. And I attended a very special training courses in my local area physically. It was a very intensive program that gave me so many skills to be a full stack developer. I know what we learned at school was important, but that training courses gave me a more competitive advantage because it was very implicated in order to provide you skills that are in demand in the IT space. That is why a few people are disappointed about the academic curriculum, since they tend to be very theoretical instead of practical. After this, I had a great portfolio. Your portfolio is your weapon. Mine was very interesting because I had so many projects I worked on. Front-end development project, back-end development project, APIs, some integration, as well as some mobile development because I wasn't sure yet what I should do. I was interested with anything. So during a recruitment process, I had so many things to talk about. I could have some long technical discussion with the person interviewing me. I don't know about you, but where are you in that equation? Do you have some competitive advantage over the people that apply to the same job than you? My first interview was a killer one because I could be able to select 2 projects in my portfolio to demonstrate that I was capable to do the job. And of course, I got selected. Let's note that before even being a career path, software development started to be a passion for me. So since the beginning, I was able to put in at least 10 hours per day to sharpen my skills. That is how I got my first software development job, just 1.5 years after I terminated my secondary school, even though I still had 2 years to complete my bachelor degree, since it was pending. More importantly, people tend to forget that if you are a genius and no one knows you are a genius, you may not be useful at all. So you have to expose yourself to opportunities outside, go to local meetup, attending some conferences or workshop online, interacting with people in order to be seen and to be known around you. We never know where the recommendation can come in order for you to take that advantage to have a job or an opportunity that will skyrocket your career. And what about even starting a technical blog to show what you are learning during your journey? I used to do that since the beginning of my tech career. And I do remember so many times already, people calling me to present me an opportunity because they have seen one of the articles that I release online. I wrote for so many platforms already, for numericaideas, the community that I'm building right now, for other well-respected platforms like Baidu, where you can see so many Java articles that I release, and a cloud provider. Be creative is also an essential skill to have. I do remember so many workshops that we have done during some physical courses or some online courses that I have took on the side. I changed a few stuff on them and even creating something very similar in order to still practice what I learned and show them in my portfolio. And nowadays, I don't even know how many projects I have done before because they are a lot. That is all that I had for you today. I hope it is useful. If you have any question in regard to your own experience, do let me know in the comment below. And don't forget, we have a world community to support you. Bye and see you in the next video. The most important action you can take right away to support us are to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be kept posted of new videos, or register to our newsletter to be amongst the first to read our technical pieces, and join our Discord server to interact with like-minded people.